welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, we are back with a casual fun baking session. And as you've already read from the title, it's all about no bake cookies. Now, today morning, I was just feeling a lot of craving for, you know, bakery items because I am very weak when it comes to especially muffins and cookies. I absolutely love them. I might be diet conscious and sugar conscious, but if you bring me those in front of me, I don't care about anything in the world. I will just eat them. So I thought, why not make no bake cookies, because there's some logistic errors with me. I don't have an oven at home right now, and I don't even have the patience to make them and not even the time to make them. So this will be a quick 5 to 10 minute recipe. Of course, you will need some time for the cookies to dry out, but yes, I am really excited to try it out because I'm doing it for the first time. As interesting as it sounds, I'm sure it will be as interesting to make as well. And I came across this a couple of months ago and I've been wanting to try it for a very long time, and today is the day. Today we are trying it out, and I thought I'll share the entire process with you guys as well, and then we for ourselves can decide if the recipe is good enough or not. So yes, let's just jump right into the video. So the first one is the classic chocolate peanut butter cookies. They have a very rich, chewy and fudgy texture, and I will be making those. These are my ingredients. I'll take you through them in a bit, but right now they are the most easiest thing on this planet. All you need is butter, quick oats, cocoa powder, peanut butter, milk and granulated sugar. I will mention all the quantities in description bar below. Now take the butter, sugar, milk and the cocoa powder in a vessel and let it come to a boil. Keep your flame on medium heat, and once the entire mixture comes to a good boil, make sure that you keep it boiling for 1 minute exact. This is quite essential for the consistency of the cookies. Now once that is done, pour the entire mixture to a mix of oats and peanut butter. This is how my mix looks after blending everything together. Once that is done, spread out your baking paper on the tray and start making small balls out of the mixture. Flatten them out with the help of your fingers or even with the help of a spoon. So guys, I'm done doing the first batch of my chocolatey peanut butter cookies, and they look insanely delicious. Keep it aside for some time so that they dry out. You can even keep it in the refrigerator for them to cool down a little more early. So yes, I'm going to do that, and in the meantime, I'll just hop on to my next recipe.
For this one, you will need some dates, 10 to 12 dates, quick oats, some raisins, some walnuts, and butter. Now grind the seedless dates and raisins in a food processor until you get a coarse mix. Add a little water if you'd like, and this is how your mix should be. Now I will add this mix to butter. I'll also add some chopped walnuts in it and some grated coconut for a nice flavor and taste. Now mix everything very nicely and start making out balls as done previously. Lay them out on a plate covered with baking paper and follow the same pressing technique as done before, and yes, you're ready with dates and raisin cookies.
So now it's time for tasting. I have both these cookies with me, the chocolate and the dates cookies. So I'll try this one. Now these cookies are not as crispy as you'd like them to be. They are like soft if you now eat it. It's soft, it's not a cookie. It's like an energy bar that you'd like before going to the gym. Or you can even eat it when you're very hungry in the night. Or even as a breakfast bar. So they are very good for that. I don't really like the chocolate flavor in it because I'm not a very chocolate person. So maybe if you like cocoa powder a lot, you will relate to it and you will like it more. And you can preserve it in the refrigerator for like 10-15 days in an airtight container. Now the next one, they are also like a little, you know, soft and sticky. Again, not crispy. Let me try this out. They are much better than the chocolate ones. I like the taste of this better because they are very easy to make. You need not even use a gas, just mix some ingredients and you're all set. And they'll be like a perfect energy bars because they do not have any sugar in it. This is nice. I like the taste of it. It is very nice. I'd prefer the other one over the previous one, but it completely depends on you and your taste buds. If you like a lot of chocolate and peanut butter, I love peanut butter, but I'm not a chocolate fan, but still I like the dates one better. So yes, that's all from me for this video, guys. I hope you liked it. If you did, then don't forget to give it a big fat thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I do a lot many videos on travel, lifestyle and DIYs as well, so don't forget to check them out. And yes, that's all for today then. See you soon in my next video. Till then, stay happy. Bye bye.